Hey everybody, it's Axel Azule. I'm back! And you may be wondering, Axel, why have you been gone for over 3 months other than one video? And to that I say, I'm sorry. My original plan was to have a video almost every day during the summer, but I had a crazy summer. So I'll explain that throughout the video. But throughout the summer, I've been playing Minecraft a lot of the time. I've had, maybe every couple hours, I'd have 5 minutes to play Minecraft. And that eventually added up to be a crap ton of time. So I've built a ton of stuff. I've probably, quadrupled the amount of stuff I've had last episode. Mostly automation. And that's why this episode's called, I don't know the title, it's going to be like the Automation-a-thon or something. Let's get right into this. Sorry, my game's laggy. Let me try to fix that. Video. I'm going to put it down to 7 chunks. Because I'm just that crazy. It is still laggy. I guess because I have so much going on right now. And all I have is a Mac. So, in my cobblestone room, I've been going good. There's this. And there's this. And there's this. And there's this. And there's that. And you may think, Axel, that's not that much cobblestone. Let me tell you. I used about 8 normal chests full of cobblestone on a build that I will be showing later in this episode. So, just stay tuned for that. So, in the room, you may notice all my ores are gone. I have some golden swords. I've been in the nether. Wood chest, yada, yada, yada. Oh, see right here, I built myself a fridge. Boop. See, you just hit the button and it opens and you got yourself some food. Get some cookies. Okay, don't want any cookies anymore. Stop giving me cookies. I want to show the people what else I have in here. Here we go, also bread. So I have changed my diet to be just cookies and bread. Om nom 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 nom. And I have some mob stuff here. And you may think, Axel, that's a crap ton of mob stuff. But I will be showing that a bit later. And now it's time for the big map reveal. Da na 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 da. So as you can see, I have been at work a crap ton. So yeah, that's... Oh, wait, this thing isn't fully loaded in. Let's see. Yep, and click. There we go. So I'll start running you through where all this stuff is. This is the pit. I will be showing you the pit in a few minutes. It's actually a really awesome thing. You're going to love it. You're going to think I'm a crack... It's such a crazy thing. You're going to think I'm a crackhead for building it. Yeah, for lack of a better term. This is a giant lapis lazuli thing. I was going to make a building out of this, but I'm not sure. I need more wool. This is the bubbly pub, the saloon here in Stranded City. It's not done yet. Up there is going to be a second floor, but as you can see, you got your bartender area here. You're going to have windows and some chairs and tables. It's quite nice. So next over here, you have your nether house. So as you can see, it has the 3 spires, which is pretty cool. And it's all fire. And here, it's quite nice, you'd have to say. And you get a nice view of the forest right here. And if this was 10 years in the future when Thinknoodles populates the Noodle Planet, his treehouse would be right there. I'm pretty sure that's the exact tree. No, it is too close to the water. That tree back, one of those trees back there would have been, it will be his house. Which is pretty sweet. And also, oh my gosh, this game is lagging. Up here you got a little second floor. I haven't had time to refurbish any of the house. Little balcony, you can see it better. And now, here is the Junglewood house. I don't know why you're open. This is the first house I built out of these 3 buildings. You see it's got the pink glass to match with the pinkish wood. I'm not the hugest fan of jungle wood, but I decided to build a house, and I'm very happy with the product. Still, I haven't furbished anything. I'm so lazy. But that's coming along quite well. The rest of this isn't quite much. That is eventually going to be a massive bridge from here to there, because that's kind of my dream project, building a super massive Minecraft bridge. Don't look at that. That's a secret. And here, you see this building. Other than the bubbly pub, this is my most recent building. You may recognize it if you watch the popular YouTuber Craner Commentates as his house from his Crundycraft series. I was watching Craner and I was so inspired. Craner's such a cool guy. And actually, I was in one of Craner's videos in one of his early prison episodes. You can actually see me standing right in front of him, except he was invisible, so I had no idea that he was standing directly behind me. And when I saw that in his video, I screamed like a little girl for 5 minutes straight. So in honor of that moment, I built his house from Crundycraft, pre-Sunday destroying it. And got a crafting table. I need to put some chests and stuff to make it more realistic. And that will be explained more later. So, I told you, there's a lot of automation. This is my newest automated farm. I literally made it like a day or two ago. This is an iron golem farm. And you may be wondering, where did all these villagers come from? Well, my villagers weren't really breeding much despite all this time. So I asked PS if he had any survivors. And actually, he had a lot of them cooped up. So I did the thing only a normal person would do. I locked all the survivors up in this farm. Perfect idea. So as you can see, all these doors count as doors in a village. So iron golems will spawn in here and drop down the hole, which makes it an iron golem farm. I saw an Enderman particle. And that's an dirt from an Enderman. The Endermen have been all over this place. Oh, and down here is just a little chamber. Here's where I keep all my doors for no reason. Down here, there's nothing. It's just a hole. I was thinking of making like a subway station of nether portals and stuff, but I don't know how that's going to work out. It's so laggy. So as you can see, stuff, they fall down here and they come here. But you may ask, Axel, how do you kill them? They don't die from fall damage. You can't drown them. So how do you slaughter all these iron golems? Well, it's quite simple, actually. Axel-y. You see those signs right there? There's lava there. And so their face is rubbing the lava, so they're rubbing their faces all over lava. And when they die, the iron spawns at their feet. So it goes into the chest. And as you can see, I have a whole lot of nothing in that chest, but that's because of this thing, and don't mind that, I'll tell you about that in a minute. So that's this little chamber. So, yeah, iron. Infinite iron. So my second farm. Well, here I had to get rid of the spawner because all my villagers were freaking out, but it's a nice monument to my original thing. And as you may notice, none of my livestock is here anymore. Hello, Clyde. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna turn down the render distance even further. Now, if it's still lagging, I'm gonna be angry. None of my farms will probably work now because it's such a low render distance. So right here, you've got yourself an sugarcane farm. And as you can see, it got sucked out of there. Once again, don't ask me about that. I'll tell you guys in a few minutes where all these materials are going. So this thing works very simple. It's a very simple design. Actually, I have no clue how it works whatsoever. All I know is that it does work. So you have your redstone repeater here. Hi, squids. You've got your redstone here. Another redstone repeater. This sand is on top of a piston. And right here you have a furnace with exactly 14 items in it. Oh, you just saw it work right there. So as you can see, the redstone runs around here, but it's not powering these. Now what happens is that whenever a sugarcane grows, it takes up that block in front of it, which completes the redstone circuit. So the redstone connects. It goes into the sugarcane and into the pistons, which causes every piston to go out at once. So whenever a sugarcane grows, all the pistons come out and push it over. And that's how that works. Now, this machine. This is a special farm. It's almost nighttime. But this farm is very special because it's not automated, but it's actually a glitz. This I'm playing in Minecraft 1.8.7, as you can see in the top left corner, very top left. So there's a glitz. This is a redstone clock causing these things to run out. And what this gives me infinite of is infinite powered rails. Yes, I'm seriously saying this. Now, let me give you a demonstration. I have 5 powered rails. Now watch this. Click, click, click. I have 10 powered rails. I do it again, and guess what? I have 24. Well, it should be 20, but I clicked it multiple times. So as you can see, when it hooks to this, which turns it sideways, and it gets pulled over the transparent block, which breaks it. And for reasons, whenever this happens, it drops 2 powered rails. Now, this happens for reasons, and to my knowledge, it only works in Minecraft 1.8.7. And I learned this design from, who did I learn this design from? I think it was Mumbo Jumbo. Mumbo Jumbo is the guy who showed, no, not that farm. Actually, Mumbo Jumbo didn't really help with any of these farms. He's a YouTuber, he does redstone stuff, but that farm, I believe it was the Minecraft Universe who did a video on 1.8.7 glitches, who showed me that you could do that duplication glitch. And this farm is from the Minecraft Wiki, because it's the most common iron golem farm. You usually see them above ground, but I built mine in the ground because reasons. And this, where did I get this guy from? I honestly can't remember. Just look it up and you'll find it. I'm sorry to the people who created it, but I just can't remember. And the only problem is it suits sugarcane off sometimes, but it works really well. I have infinite sugarcane for all the rest of my life. As you can see, I've planted my pumpkins. I have yet to build an automated pumpkin farm. And you may ask, why am I building all of these automated farms? It's because I will... as famously quoted by one of my favorite Minecraft YouTubers, ZDAF Plays, I want to be able to someone come into my world and say, hey, ZDAF, can you build me this? And I can say, yes, all the parts are over here. So basically, I just want to have a surplus of everything. That was quoted by ZDAF in his Super Minecraft Adventure. So, here's all my weed. I have yet to pick it because I'm lazy. And here are my cocoa beans. I have yet to pick them because I'm lazy. And over here, and oh my gosh, there's a skeleton. Hide, 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 hide. Okay, that right there is an automated fishery. Now, the way it works is you right click to throw out your fishing rod, and you right click to pull it back in, like opening a door. And you also right click to open doors. The thing is, opening slash closing doors takes priority over pulling in and throwing out your fishing rod. So the way this works is that when it's on, the door keeps opening and closing constantly. But whenever you throw a fishing line, it lands in the water source and trips the tripwire, which stops the door from opening and closing, which makes it means you're just clicking forever, and it's not pulling in. But whenever you catch a fish, catching a fish takes priority over opening the door, and so you pull the fish in, and then the door starts opening and closing again until you throw your line back out. It's kind of complicated. I don't know. I can't really quote who created this because it is the most common fishery design most people do saying like this. But for some reason, it is not working for me. I like throw one out, then I just keep fishing, and I never can I trip the tripwire again. So I just burn through fishing rods, and I only ever get one fish. So that's extremely useless, but I don't know what's wrong. It should be working. And the skeleton is spawned right at the door. But yeah, that's how the fishing farm works. I have nothing really hooked up to there because I haven't gotten it to work. Now down here, this is my mine. As you can see, it's kind of small, but this door goes up to my base in case there's like a zombie apocalypse I can get from my base to my mine, or vice versa. So yeah, it's a pretty small... Willie the Worm! This is the wrong YouTube channel. You're supposed to be on ZDAF Play Super Minecraft Adventure. It's Willie the Worm! You actually got... You got my letters. I've been sending you letters for months asking for you to come. Oh, I'm such a huge fan, Willie. I love you, Willie. Yay! So yeah, you can stick around here, Willie, in my mind. So yeah, as you can see, it goes down here. Wait, Willie? Did I see... What? That's deep. So as you can see, me and that was kind of a joke right there. Me and Willie worked together, and we mined out this entire thing. I think it's about a chunk, but when I started making this, I didn't know how to tell how big a chunk it will, where chunks began and ended. I've hit some caves, and I stopped around here around y equals 14. So as you can see, around y equals 14, I think it's y equals 14. Let me check. Yeah, y equals 14. I just started drilling out like crazy, looking for diamonds and stuff. I've only found a few, and it allows me to get tons of lava. And I also have another automated farm over here. I really hope Greg hasn't died yet, but more on that in a second. Just continues there for a little bit. This is a slime farm. Now, the way that this works, let me just take this off for the demonstration. These two chunks are slime chunks. I know this because I use the slime chunk finder to calculate where they are. So both these chunks are slime chunks, and for those who don't know, that means that slimes can spawn these chunks. Slimes can only spawn swamp biomes and slime chunks. And blah, 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 I heard someone yell in the background, lost my train of thought. So the slime spawn here. And of slime chunks, if you're below y equals 34, then only slimes can spawn, and they spawn no matter what light level. So slimes will often spawn in here. So they just bounce around, bouncy, 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 bounce, until they realize Greg. That's Greg the Iron Golem, courtesy of my iron farm and pumpkins. So they bounce around, and they're like, it's Greg the Iron Golem. And the thing about slimes is they hate iron golems. So this is what they do. They start bouncing towards, and they're like, I'm gonna get you, Greg. Yeah! And they start rubbing their faces all over the cactus. And they're like, yeah! Until they die. And then they break into smaller slimes, and then they die. And they break into smaller chunks who die. And then the slime balls go into here. And they go this way. But don't ask me about that, because I'll be talking and tell you about it in a minute. I know I've said that about these automated farms many times. Don't ask me about that. I will tell you about that in a minute. Just to prove that it works once we get to that. Boop. And that cobblestone will be very important later in the story. It's not really a story. It's a Minecraft Let's Play. So basically, that gets me slimes. And there's also a slime chunk right around here, this area, and one slime chunk all the way in the corner over there. But I haven't built farms there. And I decided I'd start strip mining over there a few days ago. I haven't had much luck yet. It's too bad. But that's it from down here. So it's a while up. So while we're walking up these stairs, I'll explain to you why I was absent. Well, I expected the summer would be pretty chill. But I was very far from wrong. What happened was, I chilled for the first few weeks of summer just to recover from school. Hi, Willie. Hug. So I just spent those few weeks recovering from school and just chilling. But then I had to pack for a vacation to the Galapagos Islands and, for a week, and then we were in the Galapagos Islands for a week. Then I got back, so I chilled for a week to recover from the vacation. Then I had to pack for a week to go, and the skeleton's gone. Then I had to pack for a week for a camping trip that lasted 2 weeks. So that was, that took up that time. Don't ask about this, there'll be more about it later. So after that, I chilled for a week, and then I think I had one more vacation. I'm not quite sure. It doesn't really matter. But after that, what I had to do is I had to do my summer homework I had from school, which took up a few weeks of working and stuff because it was pretty big homework. And after that, I was like, okay, time to start making videos. And I realized I had less than a week till school started. And I was like, fudge! Chocolate fudge! And I was so angry. And here's my fishing farm. So as you can see, the redstone clock goes and constantly opens the door. But if the trip line is tripped, as you can see, the door doesn't open. But once I pull the line back in, it starts going again. And with these, as you can see, there are fishing rods coming out. What happens is the clock hits this dropper, which spits out a fishing rod. If I that way, your inventory will be completely filled up with stuff like this. So only if your hand holding the fishing rod is open, you'll catch the fishing rod. If not, it'll fall in the hopper and go back into the scene. And you put fishing rods in there. And that's how that works. And if you catch a fish, it falls in... I can't even remember how my own machine works. Down there. Yeah, this pressure plate that stops the water. It goes in... the fish hit there, go in there, and then they drop down here. I was planning on having a massive chest room, but then I realized it wasn't really working very well. And so, yeah, I need this redstone torch probably. And I probably want a torch in here. Because there already is. So there's going to be a massive chest room if I get it to work. And in here, I have 55 raw fish, 12 raw salmon, a clown fish, 12 puffer fish, a bowl, an enchanted book with respiration 3 and bane of arthropods, which is pretty cool, 3 rotten flesh, 2 leather, 1 tripwire hook, and a stick. So pretty successful in like the few times it's actually worked. Which is pretty nice. I'm gonna have to improve the design soon, get it to work. I don't know why it wasn't working for me. Maybe I have the distance wrong, maybe I'm at the wrong height. I'm gonna look over some more designs and see if there's anything I can change to make it work. But it is nighttime again, so I need to go take a sleep. And then we get to the good part. Yeah, it's all pretty good. Well, yeah, the entire thing's pretty good. And we have a half moon tonight. Oh, and I haven't checked if PS has sent me any letters today. I just sleep in the Craner house when I'm too lazy to go up to my room, which is almost every night. Why can't I get in the door? Okay, I'm fine now. So, taking a little sleep, and now it's time to check for PS's letter, because he sends one almost every episode, which is pretty good. So let's check. And yes, we do have a new one. Now let's see. Mwahahahaha! You owe me 1 ender pearl, 12 dark oak saplings, and 20 bone meal. Put them in the box, nerd. Nothing on this page? Also, I like doing business with you. If you'd give me 64 gold blocks, I'll give you a villager spawner so you can save more of your crew. So that's it. So I've already put in the 20 bone meal in here, and that's for another farm. For those of you who are familiar with this type of farm, you've probably recognized it instantly, and you're like, oh, Axel, you made that farm? And yes, I did. But now, oops, I actually already showed you. I call this the massive waste of wood. Now, you probably think I'm a crackhead for using this many logs, but it's pretty cool, you have to admit. And you jump down, and the slime farm has given me enough to make this platform of slime blocks. Now, just get off this. Now, which way do you want to go first? Left, right, forwards, or backwards? Not backwards quite yet. I'm going to save left for last. So let's start with right. This is the mob hallway. Now, down here, we have our infinite water source, and we have the farm. Now, we have our gray, brown, white, and light gray seep here. Our blue and cyan seep here. Orange here. Green here, somehow red and orange got on the green pin. Yellow, purple, and pink. Purple, magenta, and pink. Sorry, Mr. Magenta Seep. And here is my ingenious cow farm. This design was from, I think this was the farm that I got from Mumbo Jumbo, but I'm not 100% sure. Now, this is how it works. Now, prepare for some lag. Now, when you hit this, redstone hits a dispenser, which puts in cows right here. Now, when the cow's right here, you get your wheat and you spam them and you start breeding all these cows. And when you're done, you put them down. Now, all the baby cows, since they're only one block high, they fall down to this hole. Now, when they're in here, they cannot escape. But this thing is hooked up to a redstone, two redstone repeaters that make this go boop, boop. So it just turns on and off extremely fast. And you'll see what happens. Dude, it dispenses lava and quickly pulls it back up. So this kills all the cows in there, which gets me, one, you didn't die? Oh my gosh. Eh. There we go. It gets me free leather and free cooked cooked steak. So as you can see, I've got five raw beef, which usually doesn't happen. It just happened that one cow died early. 11 leather and 16 steak just from that load, which is pretty sweet if I do say so myself. Now, I still, after playing for months, I've still seen like only one chicken in my world, so I don't have any chickens, and I haven't had time to bring pigs over, and I plan on building a similar machine for the pigs. Now, continuing down this hallway, you may see I'm still using stone. I upgraded to just using iron tools, but it just happened my iron tool broke when I had no iron with me, so I had to make a stone tool, and I'm using it till the durability gets used up. Now here you might recognize this is a mob farm. Now there's no lights in here, there's a creeper and a skeleton over here, and how it works, mobs spawn on these four platforms. Then they're stupid, so they walk into the water. The water pushes them into the hole, and they fall down to their deaths. Which is pretty sweet, and I'll close this off so I won't lose the, so the light won't hurt. So the farm will still work at peak capacity. And now, once we're down here, they fall down about 30 blocks. It's way too many, but I just did it because I'm stupid. They fall and they die on these hoppers. They then drop their stuff. And I haven't looked in this thing in like over a week, so I'm expecting it to be pretty full. Whoa! I expected it to be full, but not that full. Okay, so as you can see, I have an absolute crap ton of supplies. Ooh, glowstone and redstone, I'll take you. And sugar, I'll take you. And sticks, I can always use more sticks. Yeah, as you can see, this farm works pretty well, considering, actually I left it, during my school day all, day for one school day, so it works pretty well, though. So, as you can see, I've got all the gunpowder, arrows, bones, run flesh, string, etc. that I would ever need. Plus, the witches drop these stuff. And I also get the occasional spider eye, which is quite nice. So, I can make pretty much, I've got automated brewing stuff. And so, yeah, that is pretty dang sweet. Yeah, continuing, while we walk up here, I'll continue my story. Once I started school again, I've had a crap ton of homework, I haven't been able to start, yet, and this hallway and this hallway I'll show you in a few minutes, but first, I need to show you the nether room. This is going to be episode, I think this is episode 6. This is supposed to be what this episode was going to be about, but I got impatient considering I was gone for 3 months, so I just went ahead and made it. So, whoop-dee-dee, it's not super, it was going to be a whole episode, but now you just see it took a few seconds, and I made it all nethery. So, oh my gosh! That is a lot of, whoa. Okay, I can explain this because as you can see, I put slabs all over the freaking place. So instead of spying down there, it appears that 1,000 of them are in this area, which I have no idea how that's freaking possible. Now, as you can see, with my infinite powered rails farm, I built this. This goes about like a million blocks that all around. I plan on having like a base that's super far away from my base. This just leads up to the roof. Nothing really special except this thing. And you may be wondering, what's this? It just goes up into the ceiling. Well, that is what all the cobblestone, I told you I'd used 8 chests of cobblestone, and one ender pearl, 20 dark oak sap, one ender pearl, 20 bone meal, and about like 12 dark oak saplings, I believe. Oh, and by the way, PS gave those to me because it got fixed in like it uses a glitch that got fixed in 1.8.2 or 1.8.3, and I wanted it to be in 1.8.7 so I could exploit all the powered rails. So as you can see over here, I have nothing in particular. It's just some slabs and stuff. You may be thinking it's bedrock, so you're at the maximum height you can go. Well, I threw my ender pearl and boom, I went through the bedrock, and then ba-da-da-da. You may be thinking, Axel, did you use creative mode to break through bedrock? And I say, no, because I'm pretty sure that only works in Pocket Edition now. How this worked up until like Minecraft 1.8.2 or something is that you'd put 4 dark oak saplings here. You'd bone meal them to create a big tree. Then you'd break these 4 the bottom 4 wood, the wood here, 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 and here. Then you'd put 4 more saplings right here. And the way this worked was that when, my mouse went all funky. When it grows underneath by bone mealing it, because there's a tree on top of it, it has a chance of growing down like roots. And when it grew down through the bedrock. So I broke bedrock, which is pretty freaking sweet. Now you've been wondering, what, Axel, what is this redstone system right here? Well, spoiler alert, I'm just going to tell you, zombie pigmen are going to be falling down that tube, and they land in this hopper. Now, what happens is, it goes into the first hopper, but then, instead of going sideways, because of how hoppers work, it says, first, can I go down? And here, you got 18 nuggets and 4 of other things. 4 of more nuggets. And the way this works, there are exactly 22 items in here, which makes the redstone not powered. So that makes this redstone torch not power this, so nothing can go through this. But when the item, when the hopper exceeds 23 items, if another golden nugget goes in here, that activates this redstone signal. Oops. Which goes into the repeater, which turns off the redstone torch so that one ingot can, well, that one nugget can go down and into here, and it'll eventually go down into here. I've emptied it all before. If it's not a nugget, it can't go down, so it goes here, then here. Then it'll see, is it an ingot, and it'll drop down to here. And finally, is it a, it used to be zombie flesh. But I didn't want any more zombie flesh because the chest was filling up really quickly and I don't need that zombie flesh. So I just filled it with netherrack. So if it just happens that for some random Minecraft reason, it drops a netherrack, a zombie pigment drops a netherrack, it'll go in there. And finally, for all the golden swords and other items, they go into here and this redstone clock right here activates the dropper, which tosses them in the lava, getting rid of all those pesky golden swords, and now run flesh. And here I have some of these, mushrooms. Because it's dark, they naturally spawn up here. Isn't that sweet? So they should be spreading for some reason. I'm pretty sure I've been reading up on mushrooms, and I'm pretty sure it's because I have too many in one area, so I need to spread them out a tad bit. To go up and show you this. As you can see, it's all pretty far away. So it's pretty time-consuming going between these things. So, look at this. Dunna, dunna, na 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 my render distance is really low, so it's taking a long time for me to see it. Na 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 What the heck is this, Axel? Well, this is how this works. These are massive platforms of cobblestone. When my render distance is above 10, let me just give you an example. No, I don't want to change my language. I have to set it to 10 for it to work correctly. When my render distance is set to 10, the pigmen will start to spawn. That's because we're so high up that the pigmen cannot spawn down on that netherrack down there, which is really good. And so all these guys start spawning up here. And then I simply take a snowball. And as you can see, they're all here. I wait for one to get a distance. And let me find a good one. Here we go. Boop. And then they all get mega pissed and like kill him, and they end up pushing each other down into that hole. As you can see, they're all falling down. Hundreds of pigmen coming, and my starting to lag with my computer being so weak and stuff. After doing this for about 5 minutes, I get down to 1 frame per second, so I'm gonna leave before I get to one frame per second. As you can see, they fall. Boing. Ooh, I got a golden nugget. Oh my. No. Okay, I'm setting it to peaceful mode because they're gonna all murder my face. The ones that spawn down here survived. Okay. So as you can see, one missed and it's here, but then they hit. Now let's see. Already got 29 nuggets. Zero of that. And a metric crap ton of XP. So as you can see, I just barely had 44 levels beforehand, and now, by the time I'm done, after just running for a minute or two, I already have almost 46 levels. So that got me almost 2 levels for having it on for about 10 seconds. So as you can expect, I consider that awesome. So I've got infinite gold and infinite XP. And if I wanted to, infinite zombie flesh and golden swords. But I do not quite want that, because I don't need that. If they made something that could be made of zombie flesh, like if you could make beef jerky, like in some mods, then that would be completely awesome. But unfortunately, that's not how it works. And potentially, with this design, you could also put one right next to the other if you had trap chests, but I didn't want to make trap chests. I just found it easier to make another hopper. This is really difficult to make, considering I made this before I had my iron farm, and each hopper takes 5 iron. So basically it took me like 10 hours to make this, because I had to keep finding more iron in a nutshell. And that is this farm. I don't know about you, but infinite gold sounds really good to me, and I will put my render distance back to about 5 because I'm a nerd with a horrible computer. Poor me. I'm so sad. Yeah. And also, this thing you saw, the ladder also went down. There's nothing down there. But I didn't want to go down there because I don't have any slabs down there. That's where I got all my netherrack from. I mined it from down a chamber in there, but I'm afraid it's probably filled with pigmen because of how many were near my my portal. But let's see. Actually, I did put some slabs. Actually, there's none down here. They probably all despawned because I put it to peaceful mode and I was really far away. But that is my nether area. I could show you that, but there's nothing really. Well, this is what happened. I dug super far away. Ooh, hi, pigman. Are you angry? I don't know if you're angry. Oh, no. Guard the door. Eh. Ha ha. Oh, MLG Pro, but they can still spawn in here. Oh. So, what happened is I built this really far, and I decided I was far enough because I was kind of trapped between two lava oceans. And I was like, okay, let's build the portal here. And I had some friends there, and I was like, hey guys, you know it'd really suck if I built this portal, and when I came out, I was in the middle of an ocean biome. Well, guess what happened? I was in the middle of an ocean biome. And I was like, bleep, 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 bleep. But the good thing is, I didn't really get to explore it much, but I bet I'll be able to find an ocean monument, so I'll have to remember that. But I built it even farther, and I'm about to build a new portal and see if it takes me anywhere interesting. The reason I'm doing that is, one, I want a base away from my base, like a really far away like area. And two, you never know, if I'm really far from spawn, I could spawn in something like a mesa biome and where I could get all the clay I'd want, an ice spike biome where I could get which is the only place where you can get packed ice, or a a taiga mesa biome or something, which has the coarse dirt where you can't find anywhere else, the dirt that grass doesn't grow on. Which is really sweet. So let's go back in here. And we're coming close to the end of the tour. Pigmen everywhere. And that's why I have the fence here. As you can see, it's quite nice. Now, the front hallway. And here I have... I hope it renders by the time we get in there. Da-da-da-da! My storage room. Now, as you can see, I've been starting to use the gold in my design, which is pretty nice. This top chest here, I have just stuff I had around. Here's my good sword, my Unbreaking 3, Sharpness 3, and Knockback 2. I'm not going to keep that with me because I don't want to lose it. Because it's actually a really strong sword, as you can see, stronger than a diamond sword. This one I have, it has Unbreaking 3 and Fire Aspect 1, but I'm already using up most of the durability on it, which is pretty sad. And these chests don't have anything because I don't have item frames for them yet. Crap, I fell down here. I am an idiot. Oh, no. As you can see, I hit the ocean. I built a little observatory. It's quite nice. And crap, a second time. I fell down twice. I need to build, like, a rail system. A rail to keep stupid people like me from falling in. I don't need this carpet here. So, the way I do it is I have an exit up here, and when I'm in there, I can usually break about two blocks before having to come back, before I run out of air, so I have enough time to break two blocks. I think I've broken about enough for it to be kind of an observatory. I want to break these, though, because they're annoying me. So as you can see, I have the carpet here. Here is redstone land, and I've got 9 more redstone, which is amazing. Here's emerald land. I got these from trading with villagers constantly. This is the 4 PS gave me. Those villagers actually got this from those legit spawn eggs that he gave me at the beginning of the series. Mostly from my cleric who wanted zombie flesh, which as you can see, I have a major surplus of. I have iron here. I used to have like 3 stacks of iron blocks, but the final thing, I'll show you how what happened to them. Here I have my gold. As you can see, I've been kind of productive, just a little productive, but productive. I have a couple stacks, which is, I guess that's why he wanted the stacks of gold. Speaking of that, leave a comment in the section below. Do you want me to... Give PS a stack of gold blocks in order to get a villager spawner. It would be really helpful to make Stranded City great, but you guys might consider it cheating. So, what do you think? Should I be able to give him a stack of gold blocks for a spawner? I think I probably should, but it's up to you guys. And I know I only have like 6 subscribers now, but probably like the first person who comments, I'll take their opinion. If one guy says, since I've had like 2, like from people I don't know, I've had like 1-2 comments on all my videos combined at this point, which is really sad. I'm sad now. You made me sad. Why would you make me sad? But like probably like the first 2 or 3 people who respond to this out of like the next 20 years, the first 3 people who say like yes or no, I'll probably tally up a total of 3 votes. Yay! In the diamond chest, I have a few diamonds, which is quite nice. Despite digging all of that, this is all the diamonds I have. It's very pathetic, but I'm Axel. And so you should expect me to be pathetic almost all the time because I'm Axel. It's just kind of given that if you're Axel Azuli, you're probably pathetic. Here I'm putting some of those powered rails. I've got nothing for these right now. I know, the lag must be because of all these item frames. Here I've got stone bricks. Here I've got my netherrack slash glowstone chest. And here's my gravel slash flint chest. And you know I had those eight chestfuls of cobblestone because of how much gravel I have in comparison. And then down here, the second to bottom floor, I haven't put anything down here. Here I have pumpkins, wheat. I used to have more, but I spent them on cows. Seeds, cocoa beans, saplings, beautiful saplings, wood. I've done a lot of... I used to have like one of every wood. Except I spent it all on this next thing you're going to see that I spent all my iron of. So now you probably know what I was making. Here's beef and raw food. Yuck. I have to keep the raw food away from the cooked food so I don't get malaria. Sugar cane. Cactus. Cacti. Whatever you want to call it. Nothing and nothing. Pretty sweet, huh? And I have my chest... do I have anything in these? Ooh, 6 iron. Quite nice. Because I still get iron ore from time to time. Ooh, wait. 15 smooth stone. Perfect. That's from when I was making some... the smooth stone's from when I was making some redstone stuff. So, down here, I have a little crooked staircase. Isn't it nice? And this is my enchanting room. Now, this is hooked up to some cool redstone stuff. Now, as you can see, I click on it. What do I want? I can get level 30 enchantments from all of this stuff. But whenever I step on this pressure plate, boing, it releases water that goes into here. And now because of this water, I can only do a level 7 enchantment. So that's good if you want to enchant some books. I was about to say, why aren't you closing? I would be enchanting books constantly if it didn't cost lapis. This is the lapis I have. And over here, I have the books I've enchanted. I've gotten Protection 2, Power 1, Sharpness 1, and Protection 1. And if you're wondering how I built that redstone system with the opening and closing, check out ZDAF. He's the same guy that had Willy the Worm and inspired a bunch of other stuff I did. He's like one, in my opinion, the most underrated Minecrafter on YouTube. He had like 1,000 subscribers, I think. Then Mumbo Jumbo said, hey, check this guy out. And I did. And he instantly went up to like 15,000 subscribers from like 1,000 subscribers. So yeah, he's the most underrated Minecraft YouTuber on YouTube, in my opinion at least. And I plan probably in the future having that also be one of these, like identical, except for brewing. And maybe I'll make Thinknoodle's automatic brewery machine, but I'm not that good at redstone. I suck at redstone. Like, those sorters that you saw in the nether, that literally took me about 3 hours to build. That little thing. And it's so simple. Now over here, I don't want to show you what's behind me. This is my fantastic wool room. I have a bunch of orange wool, a bunch of dark blue, a bit of light blue, a bit of yellow, one red that's pathetic, a tiny bit of pink, tiny bit of magenta, tiny bit of purple. Wait, am I getting these mixed up? Yes, that is purple. Tiny bit of cyan, because these colors over here and cyan are my newest. 15 of dark green, 20 lime, 55 brown. I don't have a black seep anymore because it died when I was pushing all my seep down on the slime blocks to get them down here. Because that's why I don't have seeps up there anymore. I push them all down. A lot of dark gray, a lot of light gray, and a ton of white. And as you can see, I designed it. I'm thinking of putting like glowstone up there to make it even brighter instead of this weird torch. But what do you think? I think I did a pretty good job designing this. It's all symmetrical on both sides. I'm OCD sometimes, so I really like it to be symmetrical. And I built it with the half slab floors, so nothing will spawn, and you can see the sides. I think it's one of my better looking builds, in my opinion. It's kind of too much stone slabs, but if you have any suggestions to fix that, post it in the comments. And now, for the big reveal, the final thing, I literally built this yesterday. This Iron Golem Farm, I actually built it like almost a week ago, but this I literally built today. Well, yesterday and today. Ba-na-na-na! An even bigger sorting machine. Now, as you saw in almost all my automated farms, they had no items inside. Why are you here, Mr. Sand? So, because they were all connected to hoppers that were going underneath the ground, and they all led into this tower that dropped down here. So they go in here, and they say, am I sugarcane? Oh, wow, that's a... Wait, here we go. Am I sugarcane? And as you can see here, I don't have the same 22 item thing, because this is a new thing I learned, but I'm too lazy to fix my nether thing. 6 of an item, then the other 4 slots you put signs in. And if not, it'll continue over here. And then, iron. Now, the reason these two are over here was originally, I will show you, oops, I hit sign. This wall led into here. I was planning on having a chest for sugarcane here and a chest for iron here. But then I decided I didn't really like that too much. I wanted to have all my automated stuff in one central area so I know it was automated. So I changed it. So these things swirl around here, and they go, and they're like, hey, bro, you have yourself some poppies. And if they do, they go in there. And finally, my newest one, hey, bro, you have any slime balls? Because all those led to a massive tower. Now, as you can see, I've used about a trillion hoppers, which means like a quadrillion iron, which would not have been possible without my iron golem farm, which I probably used. I used like at least 2 or 3 stacks of iron blocks. And let's see. As you can see, that's filled with sugarcane. This is a very good farm, and this is almost filled with sugarcane. So I'm going to cut off the sugarcane farm after all of these hoppers get filled to here, because I don't want it clogging all up there, because that would just get annoying, you know what I mean? And down here, I have, well, one, the iron thing leads into there, and 2, the poppy hooks into the iron path, so iron will go in here also. So let's see. Yes, I've got a ton of poppies, and I got 14 iron from this episode alone, I think. Yeah, because I was using my iron, like, up until right now, because I just finished the slime ball thing, then I turned off Minecraft, chilled for a few hours, then made this episode. And here, oh my gosh, 10 slime balls, yay. Well, actually, when I went down and plugged this all in, I took 8, so that means I've gotten 2 slime balls since since I started this thing. And here, all these will go on, and I plan on extending this even further and making it massive. Who knows what I'll do. Maybe I'm going to start... Yeah, I'm going to make automatic food farms using villagers and farmers. So I'll have infinite carrots, maybe infinite potatoes, maybe infinite wheat, maybe even infinite beetroot with the new 1.9 that's coming out. But I'm waiting on that. So I'll have all these hooked up eventually with different farms, but that's all my farms right now. I have no need to hook it up to the fishing thing because that would mean too much sorting. And each of these take a redstone torch, 2 hoppers, a redstone comparator, a redstone repeater, and 2 redstone dust. So redstone is not in massive supply anymore, so I can't just go dilly-dally and use them all in tons of stuff. But yeah, and I have my crafting table here, so I won't have to go out here and craft, because I have one right in front of my nether portal over here. But annoyingly, I still haven't put one in my actual sorting room, in my stuff room, so I have to run out here every time I want to craft something, which is really freaking annoying. I really need to fix that soon. Well, yeah, as you can see, and I swear on my life that none of this was spawned in, none of this was from PS, all of this was from that Iron Golem farm, because I was kind of lying. I've been playing for 3 months, like 5 minutes every couple hours, and after 3 months, that really adds up. And even just for having this iron farm around for like a week or two, it works very well. The only problem is a lot of villagers commit suicide by going in the thingy or despawning, which is weird. How can they despawn? I thought that they were specifically programmed that villagers never despawn. I think it's just a bug of 1.8.7, I believe. But I guess that's understandable considering that it's also a bug that lets me get infinite powered rails. So eventually, yes, I will hook this one up to that sorter. This one will hook up to here. This one will hook up to there. That one will hook up to here. And I'll have to build a trillion others over here. So, and I'll have a nice big wall over here so you can't really see in. Or maybe I'll leave it open because it's kind of nice to see all the machinery. I like seeing a lot of machinery, don't you? I'm just rambling on at this point, so I really need to end the episode. Because that's the tour of my entire world. So I'm really happy to be back. I'm so sorry that I had such a busy summer and that I was lazy and stuff. I promise I will do everything in my power to start making videos as often as possible. I don't know how I'm going to do. I usually make one video a day because I'm in the feel for YouTube. But after waiting like 2 hours for the video to upload, I'm no longer in the feel to make another video. But if I am still in the feel, which I'm feeling really pumped today, I'm going to try to make a video on the game I programmed right before summer began. So yeah, I programmed the game like 3 months ago and I still haven't made a video about it. Just over the summer, all I made was that Clef Key PSA, which I highly suggest you watch. It's a PSA that defends Clef Key and shows why Clef Key is one of the best Pokemon ever. Which may sound insane to some hardcore Pokemon fans, but just hear me out, he's awesome. Well, if you liked that episode, please leave a like and and a comment on the questions I've asked today. Do you want me to be able to buy spawners from PS? And I think I had one other question, but I'm too dumb to remember it. And if you would like, how about you subscribe and join the Axel Empire? Which would be really nice of you, because I'm just trying to have fun and make videos of it. Yeah, so, what's bad about a guy trying to have fun by making videos? And if, oh yeah, one thing, I forgot. Here's a shout out to Panda4334, I believe. No, it's 4554. He's an excellent guy. He's the guy who made that zombie pigman farm, the original design. And I got the design when Thinknoodles made it. So big shout-outs to both of them. And big shout-out to Zadaf Plays for being an awesome guy and stuff. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I've been Axel Azuli from Axel Azuli Entertainment. Goodbye!